I've been talking to him a lot the last 3 weeks, and obviously Novak has really pushed for this. I think it's going to be great for Andre. He still follows the game very closely. You know, he's been heavily involved with Agassi Prep and opening schools. He just opened up another one this weekend in San Antonio, and very involved in his son Jaden Agassi's baseball career, who's a phenomenal talent for 15. But I think this is a very exciting opportunity for both of them.
Now, it seems to me like history might be repeating itself, because when Andre approached you to be his coach, you had no coaching experience. It's kind of the same thing now with Novak and Andre. What do you think it is that Novak's looking for from Andre?
Well, I think, well, first of all, Andre was a bit younger when I started with him. And obviously at this point last year, Novak was 2 weeks, you know, away from becoming the first man since Labor to hold all four of the slams. The one thing that I think that Andre, you know, besides incredible knowledge, wisdom, passion that he will bring, Andre played his best tennis from 29 on for the rest of his career. Novak just turned 30. Today's 30 is no longer 30. It's like 25. And I think that Andre can really help him in this next chapter. It's not about what he's done. It's about starting from today and focusing on what they can do. And I think Andre's really excited to get on the practice courts this week and kind of get to know him, spend a little time at dinner and start to figure out what he can do to make him become a better player.
When you hear Novak talk, as he did on Sunday, about how excited he is to be working with Andre, he talked a lot about him, and not much as well about his tennis. A lot of it was about the man Andre Agassi and his life and everything else that he's achieved. What exactly is he looking for here? Is it a tennis coach or more of a life coach?
Well, I think sometimes as a tennis coach, you have to wear multiple hats. And I think more than anything, it's them connecting as people. Andre helping him simplify what he's doing on the court and maybe expand some things and get to know him better, you know, off the court. And I think that, you know, there's a balance. Some coaches want to go, you know, only work at the courts and leave, you know, and don't hang out together. In the 8 years together that I coached Andre, we went to dinner almost every night. And I think that's very helpful to really understand the person. And sometimes the best coaching can be at night when you're relaxed like that.